Hello, everyone, and welcome to week 11 of MC 305. This week, we're going to be going over all of the appeal formats for various commercials. Now, instead of producing multiple videos with each type of format, I'm instead going to use this one video and go over all the formats together, and then you can refer back to this video every day through week 13 in order to understand what each of these formats do and how you can write for them. And so this video might be a little bit longer than our typical lectures are, but it also includes some great commercials for you to find interest in and learn the various types of appeal formats. So you may remember back to our persuasion chapter about motive appeals. These are really trying to meet Maslow's hierarchy of needs, where safety and physical needs tend to be the prime needs that we need to be met, as well as love and nurture, protection, safety, self-actualization, and onward. And so using these motive appeals, we are trying to get the audience to act in a way that motivates them to do something. And so commercials tend to use five different types of formats to appeal to those motives and to get the audience to act in whatever way the commercial is trying to get them to do something. And so the first is a straight sell, followed by a testimonial, humor, music, and dramatization. And we'll go over each of those in more depth. Now, the straight sell commercial is clear, simple statements about the product or service. Most commercials fall into the straight sell category, especially ones that are more local or smaller companies. Straight sells stress what is most important about the product or the service, and you should use motive appeals to connect your product to what you think people in your audience need most. In addition, you're going to want to bring out the aesthetic considerations, what makes this a better choice over competitors in terms of taste, smell, looks, etc. You don't want to hit your audience over the head or demean them, though, in a straight sale. Just because you're being clear and simple doesn't mean that you have to continually beat them over the head with what makes your product better. You can do it in a very subtle way, but you don't want to be too subtle where someone doesn't recognize what you're trying to sell. You also want to remain somewhat neutral and detached from the product or service. So you wouldn't say our product or our services unless you have a personality that is presenting it in a combination straight sale and testimonial type format. So instead, you're going to want to talk about the product and what makes it special, but not in a way that connects it back to the brand. So here are some examples. This is the Toyota Prius commercial that is in your textbook. You can see the storyboard and script within your textbook, but be able to watch it here.
It gives the world fewer smog-forming emissions. It gives you a 50 mile per gallon rating. The third generation Prius. It's harmony between man, nature, and machine.
So as your textbook talks about, this commercial is a straight sale because it talks about the emissions and how the Prius is different from other types of vehicles. And so you're really talking about the unique benefits of owning this specific type of Prius. Here is another demonstration, an oldie but a goodie.
Recently, when I became deathly ill, I was able to summon an ambulance, my next door neighbor, my family, and my doctor without picking up a telephone. I used this remote control to contact LifeCall, my 24-hour emergency medical response service. Watch. You just press this button and speak into the air and...
I'm having chest pain.
I'm calling paramedics and your family, Mr. Miller.
I've fallen, and I can't get up.
We're sending help immediately, Mrs. Fletcher.
See? Protect yourself with Life Call, and you're never alone. To get complete free information by mail about this affordable medical emergency response system, call toll-free now. Life Call can save your life, so call to get free details by mail right away.
For free information about Life Call, call 1-800-872-9100.
So this Life Alert product, while we can consider it a little cheesy now and has become kind of the butt of some jokes, the I've fallen and I can't get up commercial, it is a straight sale and it really is effective in a lot of ways for the audience that they are trying to reach. They are trying to reach elderly people or people who need emergency services, and it shows how the product works. And so while the dramatizations are a little cheesy, it still shows the ways that the product is unique and would meet the needs of its audience.
Recently,
here is another straight sale using the comparison tactic.
If you want to know why your 3G coverage works so well on Verizon Wireless, there's a map for that. Or why you can watch videos at 3G speed almost anywhere, there's a map for that. And if you want to know why some people have spotty 3G coverage, there's a map for that too. Yep, with 5 times more 3G coverage than AT&T, there's lots of reasons to switch to Verizon Wireless. Come in now for great deals on 3G phones, like the Samsung Rogue for $99.99.
So you can see here that there is both a visual comparison as well as a linguistic spoken word comparison in the commercial between Verizon and its competitor AT&T. And what they're arguing is that their service is unique because they have larger areas of 3G coverage than their closest competitor, making this a straight sell. So here is a demonstration type straight sale.
This is Tyler. Tyler, with Grammarly's help, is writing an email to his boss, Anita. Tyler sits just 15 feet away, though it can feel like the distance to Antarctica, approximately 47 million feet. Tyler desperately wants Anita to like him, but doesn't want to sound unsure of himself. He also wants to explain the incident at the elevator. But this probably isn't the email for that. It's an email asking to lead a team workshop because more collaboration would be really helpful, beneficial. But Tyler worries that Anita doesn't think he's confident, especially after the time he told her,
"I'm a suppository of information."
And she gave him this look, since he clearly didn't know what a suppository was. This time, Tyler is determined to find the right words, the ones that will connect best with Anita, so that when Tyler sends his email, he receives a response in just 4 minutes and 12 seconds. That includes phrases like, "I'm impressed," and "such initiative." And the distance between Tyler and Anita stops feeling so far. Grammarly, helping you connect. Go to grammarly.com to download.
So you can see that this Grammarly commercial not only provides this dramatization of what happens during the typical workday to this character, but how Grammarly can fulfill the needs that he has at work in trying to communicate with his boss. And it does so in live time, allowing you to see how they're even transforming the script that they're using with Grammarly's services to make it sound even better. So the testimonial is a second type of appeal format. A testimonial user uses a celebrity or everyday person who has used the product to support the brand or product in a commercial. They're testifying about why they like this particular product. A lot of times, testimonials use emotional appeals such as prestige, power, and good taste. But you have to make sure that testimonials are consistent not only with the brand, but also the celebrity's image. And you need to make a testimonial convincing enough that an audience would believe that the celebrity really supports uses, and believes in what he or she is saying. So here is an example of how to use a bad testimonial.
Why did Hertz invent number one club gold service? To beat the rush hour. See, every plane and everybody seems to land at once. But with gold service, there's no stopping at the counters and no paperwork. Instead, you go nonstop to your waiting car with your name and lights. Only Hertz has number one club gold. The best reason yet why Hertz beats the rush hour. To Hertz, the rest of the day is a piece of cake.
So you can imagine that using O.J. Simpson as your testimonial for your product may not be the best of ideas given the things that are about to happen in O.J. Simpson's life. So the problem with testimonials is that sometimes either the product or the celebrity's image gets tarnished and therefore makes both ineffective as an overall product. Here is a better celebrity testimonial. If you did not know anything about Ed Sheeran, you should know he is one of the world's largest ketchup fans. Who knew?
I've got an idea for a Heinz ketchup commercial. I was at this super posh restaurant, super posh. The type of place that has chandeliers and paintings on the wall and way too many forks. I think classical music was playing, but maybe it was jazz. No, definitely classical. The hostess walks up to me and she says, Mr. Sheeran, is this your first time dining with us? And I say, yep. The waiter comes over, he's telling me about the specials. Super fancy, fancy vegetables, fancy sauces. I said, sounds fancy. So fast forward and the food comes. The waiter goes on to tell me, we are proud to present this farm to table, blah, 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 posh and fancy, blah, 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 with a side of blah, blah, blah. You know, the food looked good. I just thought there was something missing. So I reach into my bag and I take out the only thing that can complete me. And at that point, the whole world came to a stop. In the waiter was screaming through his eyes. So that's my idea. Do you want to do it?
So here you can see that Ed Sheeran is pretty genuine in his love and passion for ketchup. Again, who knew? But he uses his humor and unique style to be able to show how ketchup makes all of his meals better, even if it is in a kind of funny way.
Audible now, is my
product users are also really important in terms of testimonials. These are everyday people who use your services and products who recommend them to others.
Gabe?
It's like my form of meditation.
An infinite amount of stories and characters.
A better question would be, where do I not listen to it?
While I'm eating my breakfast.
On the edges of cliffs.
On a ski lift.
And being able to drive in the car and listen to a story, it's like a gift.
I listen to books about neuroscience to try and figure out why I am the way I am.
There's so much there. It literally inspired me to follow my dream.
Download Audible and start listening today.
So by hearing from real Audible listeners about where they use the product and why they like using the product, you may become more interested in using the product yourself. That's the whole idea behind a product user testimonial.
Audible is.
Now, here is a testimonial that combines product user feedback as well as a bit of humor.
I flippin' love game flings. My nose was in love at first sniff. As soon as I opened the package, my nose did the merengue dance move. The scent is amazing. Gane smells like rainbows caused by baby giggles. These smell amazeballs. My clothes came out looking clean and smelling totally fantabulous. There are no words known to mankind that can express how fabulous the Gane flings are. I love Gane flings.
So by using somewhat humorous testimonials, this commercial really combines both the product user aspect of testimonials as well as humor. Now, there are ethical considerations when using testimonials, especially when you're marketing to children. I think we could all agree that having kids talk about how ABC Mouse, an educational learning program, is fun and exciting is okay. And here's a clip of that.
ABCMouse.com is so fun. There's a ton of things to do. I go for games. Reading, math, songs, science, puzzles, painting. They never run out of things. They just make new stuff. A fun game is the shirt game.
So that's fine, but what about this latest trend in toy unboxing for kids, where kids like my daughter or my nieces who are a little bit older will sit and watch these kids unbox toys and not realize that they're watching an advertisement? Now here, you can see that it says includes paid promotion down here in the very small corner. And there will be a large full screen here in a second that talks about it as a ad brought to you by Mattel.
Sponsored by Fisher Price.
Fisher Price.
In here, there are some more bits and pieces that you don't know.
But does the average 10-year-old know what sponsored by means? Is this an appropriate way to use a testimonial for kids? Do they really know that they're watching a commercial? And is that ethical?
Whoa, Ella, look!
Is it for me and Charlie?
Are they? Well, they're actually for you because these are for big kids. Okay, so Ella's just unboxed the two of these here. So we have...
So you can see here that mom regularly receives products from Fisher-Price and does these unboxing videos as testimonials for the products. However, my 8-year-old niece happens to think that you can just grow up to be an unboxing toy star and that someone will just always send you toys, which obviously has some ethical concerns for how this company sponsors products to children. So that is certainly an ethical consideration for us to consider as both media users and media generators. So humor is one of the favorite appeal formats in terms of consumers. We all love a funny commercial. It's an effective attention getter. It's a way to capture the audience's attention and make yourself memorable. But the problem with humor is that you have to turn the attention getter that you're using into a sale. You have to make humor persuasive, and that can be very difficult to do. In addition, you really need to reflect current humor patterns, which can change from generation to generation and even year to year. What was funny 10, 15 years ago could be considered inappropriate today. For example, today we use a lot of satire and parody when even 20 years ago, satire and parody were not considered humor trends, and a lot of times they were considered disrespectful to be a parody of something else. Now, a lot of times humor is joined with dramatization to allow for that comedic effect, but the primary goal of a humor commercial is to get the audience to laugh. There are also many different types of comedy, like the bizarre, gentle comedy, or even slapstick comedy. So you need to know what kind of humor you're wanting to use. And most importantly, don't forget to sell. If you're just making something that's funny, but it doesn't represent the product very well, then you have not done your job as a commercial writer. So here is an example of a terrible humor commercial brought to you by Quiznos.
We love these subs, 'cause they are good to us. The Quiznos subs, they are tasty, they are crunchy, they are warm because they toast them. They got a pepper bar.
Quiznos new Santa Fe Trio subs with smoky chipotle sauce. Fried chicken, roast beef, or smoked turkey.
Quiznos subs!
Quiznos.
Toast. So that's one example of a bizarre humor, to say the least. Of course, Quiznos probably did not think about having rodents selling subs that you want to eat, who have weird faces and mouths that are screaming at you, may not be the funniest thing. So humor is very subjective, and you have to know that sometimes what you and your team of creatives think aren't going to go so well in the real world. Here is an example of bizarre humor that has been fairly effective for a company, though.
Hello, ladies. Look at your man. Now back to me. Now back at your man. Now back to me. Sadly, he isn't me. But if he stopped using lady-scented body wash and switched to Old Spice, he could smell like he's me. Look down. Back up. Where are you? You're on a boat with the man your man could smell like. What's in your hand? Back at me. I have it. It's an oyster with two tickets to that thing you love. Look again. The tickets are now diamond. Anything is possible when your man smells like Old Spice and not a lady. I'm on a horse.
So the Old Spice commercials have utilized bizarre humor in a way that really struck a chord with audiences, and it actually propelled Old Spice sales by a large quantity when these commercials first aired. And now I recently saw that Tide has been using a parody of the Old Spice commercials in order to sell their products. So it just shows that bizarre humor can be effective when done well. Now, slapstick humor is humor that uses physical hurt in some way to bring about a laugh. Typically, it's falls, someone getting hurt, things of that nature. Here is Reebok's attempt during a Super Bowl commercial.
When we asked Reebok to send us Terry Tate, some people thought we were crazy. But I'm a firm believer in paradigm breaking, outside the box thinking.
Hey, buddy.
Was over 15 minutes ago, Mitch!
And since Terry's been with us, our productivity has gone up 46%. We're getting more from our employees than ever before.
You know you need a cover sheet or your TPS reports, Richard! That ain't new, baby!
Hey, Terry.
Hey, Janice!
But what's really impressed me is how Terry's become part of the Felcher family.
How did you get high, baby?
He fits right in here. To be honest.
So here you can see that Reebok has attempted to use humor with Terry Tate tackling regular office workers and screaming at them in order to achieve that slapstick comedy. Some people considered it very effective, while other people thought it took a step too far. Now, in terms of slapstick, no one perhaps is better than Bud Light, literally.
This round of Bud Lights on me.
All right, thanks, Steve.
Yo, Steve, fist bump is out, man.
Really? What's in? Cool.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Nice job in there, Larson. You saved the account.
Yeah, don't suggest slapping your boss, even if it is slapstick comedy. Again, this type of humor appeal hits with some people and misses with others, so you have to be very careful when using slapstick not to take it too far. Here is a great example, a local example of gentle humor that tends to be very effective.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide, y'all.
Roll Tide,
my friend.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Get sauce. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
It's such an honor. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide?
Yep.
Y'all don't even know he was a virgin until he's 28, and now, Roll Tide.
Hi, Mary and Daisy. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
He will always be remembered. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
So that's considered a gentle humor appeal because it uses a phrase, pokes fun at, but doesn't step too far across the line. Here is an Alexa commercial that also uses gentle humor.
forgot to reheat pasta?
Reheating pasta. It's cool, right?
Yeah, I didn't know you guys put Alexa in a microwave.
Yeah, we're putting her in a lot of stuff now. But trust me, there are a lot of fails.
Like what?
Like...
Alexa, play my podcast.
When you heard that, did that surprise you? Bart seems exciting.
We made an Alexa dog collar. Four dogs.
Ordering dog food. Ordering dog food.
You can bark all you want. I'm not paying for any more dog food.
Ordering gravy. Ordering sausages.
Hey, you better cancel that order.
Alexa hot tub? A sucked.
Alexa, play music.
Okay.
And then there was the incident.
Wait, that was you guys?
I don't know, was it?
Powering down. Powering up. Powering down.
She says she's doing it, but I don't see anything.
Do you? Holy.
Don't stop me now.
I'm not talking to you.
Cause I'm having a good time, having a good time.
So again, you can see that gentle humor tends to be the most effective type of humor for writers because it allows you to get a good laugh without offending people. Now, here is a commercial that offended a lot of people, so much that it was actually banned in the country that it originated from. However, I still think it has a pretty effective message.
Zazu condoms. Fun, sexy, safe.
So it's important when writing humor commercials to try to avoid sexual humor and any race or cultural humor that could be considered offensive. However, I will go to my grave thinking that's an extremely effective commercial. So music is another type of appeal format that is very important to the commercial business. Now, music can either be used in tandem with words, or it can be used as the sole persuasive element of a commercial. Now, music is important because it predisposes the audience to a product and associates a particular song or feeling of nostalgia to that product as well. Jingles are an important part of selling things. I mean, you can think of ba-da-ba-ba-ba, and you already know what product I'm thinking or singing about. And so jingles can be an effective form of appeal writing. In addition, already known songs, very popular or poppy songs tied to a product can make that song a persuasive appeal, getting your audience in a particular mood to set up for the sell. And then music also allows for emotional connection, both happy and sad, to a particular commercial. So here is an example that was given in your textbook from Clorox.
Life is sweet when I can touch you. Thursday, I'm feeling merry. Can't help smiling.
We touch a lot of things throughout the day, so it's nice that Clorox disinfecting products help kill the germs that can live on surfaces for up to 48 hours.
So here the advertisers have combined the song along with some verbal text that allows it to sell the idea. But sometimes you can use just a jingle and tell the entire story that you want. Here is the 1988 infamous Kit Kat commercial. Sorry if you have that stuck in your head for the rest of the day. But jingles are effective ways to help audiences remember your product. And in fact, they really help as key repetition tools as well to keep your brand and product top of mind for your audience. Music can also be emotional. And I promise I won't play this very long because I don't want you guys to start crying in the middle of the video. So you can see that the ASPCA has paired this emotional song from Sarah McLachlan with these terribly sad images of pets in order to encourage donations to their cause. So it's really using music as a form of emotional appeal. So another way to use music is by connecting it to popular or pop music. And Beyonce, during the Super Bowl a couple of years ago, was one of the first artists to use her own music to promote her own brand for the Formation World Tour. And here is the commercial that allowed her to be one of the pioneers for the music business doing that. And of course, the Formation World Tour went on to be one of the best-selling artist tours in history. And a lot of experts believe that the buzz generated from this commercial and its innovative way of having a pop artist promote themselves through their music was partly responsible for that. Of course, it's Queen Bey, so who wouldn't want to go to see her tour? Now, here is a music commercial that seems all right on its face, but in the end is actually in very bad taste.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
So unfortunately, Geico didn't really do much research, apparently, because that song was by the Allman Brothers, who happened to die in a motorcycle crash. So this is why researching the elements of your commercial, from the types of images that you're using, the words you choose, as well as the music, are really important, because Geico had to pull that commercial due to its insensitivity to the Allman Brothers members who died in that motorcycle crash. Now, dramatization is also a very popular format for an appeal commercial. Dramatization is essentially a short play told in 30 to 60 seconds. So it follows the basic steps of storytelling and persuasion. exposition, conflict, rising action, climax, and sometimes resolution. The idea behind a dramatization commercial is that it gets the audience's attention and interest, creating suspense and wanting you to know what is going to happen for the character in order to help them solve that problem. I have shown the Volkswagen commercial where the child is trying to use the force a bunch of times, but I think that it is a wonderful example of dramatization. So I won't show it again, but know that that is a great storytelling example in terms of dramatization. Here is the commercial that your textbook refers to with the Levi's Buttonfly 501 jeans. Here we have Wesley Snipes kind of dancing around with some other people. I don't really know that it has a true story, but it kind of tells a feeling or an emotion that the company wants you to experience when you wear their Buttonfly jeans. Every late night morning I put on my blue Levi's Buttonfly 501 blue. Well, they shrink down to fit you and only you. They Buttonfly, yeah, don't it make you wanna that's the truth. Yeah, my radio's busted, my rent's coming due. But I'm still looking like front page news when I button fly. I'm a 501 blues. That's true. Levi's 501 blues. So while I might not consider that one of the most effective uses of dramatization, it does tell its own story. It gives the audience a feeling about what you might experience if you were wearing these jeans. And I always want to show you the actual video version of what your textbook is addressing, which is why I've included it here. Here is another example of a dramatization in terms of an inspiring story.
We're never alone. And that is our strength. Because when we're doubted, we'll play as one. When we're held back, we'll go farther and harder. If we're not taken seriously, we'll prove that wrong. And if we don't fit the sport, we'll change the sport. We know things won't always go our way.
And the world's sporting events are postponed or cancelled.
But whatever it is, we'll find a way. And when things aren't fair, we'll come together for change.
We have a responsibility
to make this world a better place.
And no matter how bad it gets, we will always come back stronger. Because nothing can stop what we can do together.
So thanks to creativity in both writing and visual storytelling, that commercial produces a great drama that an audience can focus on and pay attention to. Now, dramas can also be very serious. This commercial was one of the first to play during the NFL Super Bowl after various players had been charged with sexual abuse. And so the NFL donated as Super Bowl commercial time, which obviously is very expensive, in order to allow for No More, the nonprofit, to produce this wonderful commercial.
Hello?
911, operator 901, where's the emergency?
127, bring there.
Okay, what's going on there?
I'd like to order a pizza for delivery.
Ma'am, you've reached 911. This is an emergency line.
Large with half pepperoni, half mushroom.
You know you've called 911. This is an emergency line.
Do you know how long it'll be?
Okay, ma'am, is everything okay over there? Do you have an emergency or not?
Yes.
And you're unable to talk because...
Right, right.
Is there someone in the room with you? Just say yes or no.
Yes.
Okay, it looks like I have an officer about a mile from your location. Are there any weapons in your house?
No.
Can you stay on the phone with me?
No. See you soon. Thank you.
So by using an actual 911 call, that PSA provides us with the drama of a real life situation paired with visual images from that victim's scene. And it really tells a very powerful story about how we need to be listening to assault victims, listening out for cues when things don't sound right. Now, dramas can also be romantic in the ways that they tell stories. Here is the classic love story dramatization for commercials.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Oh, would it be a sin? Oh, if I can't help falling in love with you. Oh, like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so
give extra, get extra.
So that commercial obviously pairs both the music format with dramatization in order to tell a romantic story of this couple's meeting up to their proposals. And guys, you better step up your gum game. That's all I can say. So mixed formats are commercials that combine all of these formats in various ways. I've pointed out some, like the Wrigley's commercial, the Extra commercial, that just use both music and drama to really tell a story. Mixed formats can also include mini drama series where you have the same characters who appear across multiple ads and campaigns to tell different types of stories. That would also be considered a mixed format. Now, the idea behind a mixed format is that you would use one method to grab the attention of the viewers and use other types of formats to hold on to them. You shouldn't ever try to just fit all of them into one commercial. Only use the tools that you feel are necessary to improve the appeal. So here are some mixed format or combination formats that are deemed effective. This is the commercial that your textbook refers to for combination formats from IBM.
In this rapidly changing world, even the brightest and best manager in the company
We need more than a loyal staff to run a smooth operation. For when headquarters calls and pressure builds, it becomes harder to keep things rolling without running into mix-ups, losing control of the operation, and falling behind. For rapid improvement, a manager could use a tool for modern times, the IBM personal computer, for smoother scheduling, better planning, and greater productivity. It can help a manager excel and become a big wheel in the company. The IBM personal computer. See it at a store near you.
So that commercial combines dramatization, where you see a story being told of the Charlie Chaplin character throughout the commercial, as well as humor, because you get to see that slapstick comedy that that celebrity was known for. And then you also get the influence of the music going from chaotic to smooth to emphasize the solution that IBM provides its customers. So here is an example of a mini series that also uses humor, and you might be familiar with these.
I'm your blind spot, and my job is easy. Hide big things.
You're good.
And with your cut rate insurance, you could be paying for this yourself. So get Allstate. You can save money and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Mayhem is everywhere. So get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
I'm the world's worst cleaning lady. Cleanliness was supposed to be my middle name. But then my parents settled on Janet. Now, I'm here in your home having a pretty spectacular Tuesday. But I don't notice the loose rug at the top of your stairs. And that's about to become an issue for me. And if you've got the wrong home insurance coverage, my medical bills could get expensive. So get Allstate, where agents help keep you protected from mayhem, like me.
Good hands, good home. Make sure you have the right home protection. Talk to an Allstate agent.
So, of course, the Mayhem commercials have many different series of them. In fact, for some reason, insurance commercials like Geico and Allstate tend to use miniseries quite frequently. You can think of the Gecko or even the Cavemen series from Geico. Those would all be considered mini drama series. So here is an example of a combination of testimony and music, as well as a little bit of a straight sell. And it's done in a very unusual way by shooting a music video for Selena Gomez.
You promised the world and I fell for it. I put you first and you adored it. Set fires to my forest and you let it burn. Sang off key in my chorus, 'cause it wasn't yours. Yeah, we'd always go into it blindly. I need to lose you before me. This is killing me softly. I needed to hate you to love me. Yeah, to love, love you, to love.
So the idea behind this commercial is that Selena Gomez believes in the iPhone 11's capabilities so much that she would shoot her music videos using only an iPhone. So that's the testimony present. Then, of course, you have her music video adding to the appeal element of that. And then you also get a demonstration or straight sale based on what the iPhone does and what you're seeing. Here is another dramatization that uses music to tell the story.
Hey.
when I wake up, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. And when I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you.
So here Budweiser has created a very cute, adorable story that the audience can follow through a drama. And they emphasize that with music that also talks about, you know, being lost, being willing to go the extra mile for your friends and things like that. So that would be a combination format as well. So what does all this mean? How can we learn from this? Well, you're really trying to remember that you are selling a product and not the commercial. You can create the best, entertaining, funniest, or saddest commercial out there. But if someone can't connect what you're selling with the idea that you're presenting it with, it's not a very effective campaign. Persuasive appeals are tools, but the end goal is to get the audience to take the desired action. So you always want to remember the brand whenever you're writing. However, you can use these five different appeal formats in order to help you do just that. So now that we've talked about the different types of appeals, you can do your discussion post for today on the types of appeals formats, and then you will do your critique in order to find a good and bad example of each of these format types. Then refer back to these slides for the next few weeks when I tell you to watch a video on straight sell or testimonial. You can use this video as that video so that you can remind yourself what those format expectations are. And as always, refer back to your chapter as well.